Well, I think he was aggressive with all of his stuff in the zone. I definitely think he made strides with his splitter. That's the best I've seen it in the last couple outings. Although I've seen it from the side, being able to catch it today, I've definitely seen some more depth with the pitch. He used it a lot more, I would assume, I think. I mean, I don't really know the numbers, but slider to both sides, fastball to keep him honest. That's vintage Massa right there, owning the bottom part of the zone, commanding both sides, and really not letting guys get too comfortable.
He's now throwing the ball extremely well as well. Do you think he's fueled by that, trying to match him, put up zero?
I don't know. That'd be a good question for him. He tends to always step up for us in big games. You know, he's going against, you know, one of the best pitchers in the game, and, you know, he always gives us a chance to win a game. Today, he just kept going out there and putting up zeros. And when you do that, it allows us to chip away at these good pitchers and get guys on and try and scrape across a couple runs. We definitely did. And he came out and I think he had a four-pitch last inning. So, I mean, it was showing you the movement on his pitches and the uncomfortable swings that were happening.
That hit in the fifth seemed as big as it felt with the way that Snell had been pitching your double.
I was just glad I could get on. You know, there's two outs there. I hit a ball pretty hard in the gap. And, you know, I'm immediately thinking I got to be on second base, you know. So I'm busting out of the box, and Tock's been swinging the bat really well for us. So there's a lot of confidence that he's going to get a good hit. And, you know, he puts one off the wall. So, I mean, and then we just start going. DJ comes up, does what he's been doing, hitting the ball everywhere. And we just kind of started to roll a little bit there. And you got to take the runs when you can get them, and especially with two outs.
How strange was the 43-minute power outage delay?
I mean, I've never seen that here. I've been coming here since 11, so it was weird. All part of it, I guess, is treat it like a rain delay, I guess. But, you know, just stay ready, hit in the cage, and be ready to go back out there and turn it up when the lights come back on. But it was definitely weird.